Tina Costa and Lindsay Arnold, friends, staff, you name it, they're always there. They work for me, they work with me, they have other careers, but they help make this happen, and I appreciate it very much. Many people. Welcome to Casa de Buena Esperanza, the house of good hope, the house that MIT built. Before hope became a popular buzzword, CASA earned its name. And long after hope gives way to a newer, trendier buzzword, CASA will endure. During the trials and tribulations of building this house, I was waiting for our home to tell us its name. I would know it when I heard it. And during a particularly trying time, the name just came to me. Casa de Buena Esperanza, the house of good hope. In Spanish, there's a wonderful word for which there is no English equivalent. The verb esperar means both to wait and to hope. It embodies the cultural value of believing, always, that tomorrow is a better day, a chance to reinvent oneself. It also embodies the cultural value of patience, understanding that good things don't come quickly or easily, but rather, they require persistence. MIT embodies these very same values. The world over, MIT is viewed as a beacon of hope for the future. Forget about the rankings and periodicals. That is not MIT's true strength. MIT's strength is in the worldwide awareness of what MIT represents and what it seeks to achieve. When we travel away from these bastions of overeducation, and we mention the word MIT, always a look of reverence passes on the listener's face. And then, hushed tones, the words, oh, yes, MIT. That is the strength of MIT. Its message is universal. I remember all too well the first time I heard of MIT. I was a young girl in Fresno. My father had immigrated from Lebanon that decade. In one of his many talks he gave me while growing up, he told me the following tale. And please forgive the geographic imprecision of California. There are two schools down the street from each other in Boston. At one of these schools, all of the world's problems are created. The latter is called MIT. That is MIT's strength. Of course, my father did not know that one day I would fall in love with a young man from MIT whose father had attended MIT on a ROTC scholarship. He did not know that MIT would be the cause of such fortunes earned by these two men. He did not know that my life would be profoundly impacted in so many ways by MIT. And he would never have dreamed that one day I would have the honor of welcoming the president of MIT and $150 into my home. When I was planning this event, I wanted to create centerpieces that symbolized MIT. And I settled upon a collection of mortar and pestles from around the world. Please do take the time to walk around and enjoy them. The mortar and pestle are tools that have long been used by people all over the world. Probably every culture in the world has its own version. These simple objects represent the universality of man's need to create tools to improve his life. And MIT embodies that need. MIT brings together people from all over the world, the best and the brightest, and sets them upon the task of improving through math, science, technology, tools, all of our lives. I bought these mortar and pestles from Barbara at Gourmet Sleuth, and when I told her why I wanted so many, she became so excited that she sent me an extra one, her personal favorite, just because she wanted the Indonesian mortar and pestle to be part of this event. calls people to action. That is MIT's strength. I tell you these stories because I think of no better way to share with you the power of your investment in MIT. You must already know this, or you wouldn't be here today. But I'm a little bit of an overachiever. And I couldn't have a whole group of MIT donors come to my house to be fed, and then let them walk away wondering if they had actually been fed. That just wouldn't do. So I will end as I began, and now I hope you can grasp the depth and the sincerity of this welcome as I offer it again. Welcome to Casa de Buena Esperanza, the house of good hope, the house that MIT built.